For the first time in history, most of us live in cities, where cement covers the earth and buildings stand where trees once lived. I'd like you to remember the last time you touched the bark of a tree or put your hand in the soil of the earth. What did it feel like? What was that experience like? Can you remember a time when you were walking in a field of woods or on a sunny mountain path with the sun on your back? Feel that experience. Can you imagine having that connection with nature in the city?
Well, the garden is designed as a whole, so you can sort of like extract one part as most significant, because you need to look at it as a whole thing. The garden is designed as a miniature mountain and water. So this is what it is. That's the mountain and that's the water. This is just a tradition. Since the first day that the Chinese garden was born, like the private garden, according to the historical record, probably the 3rd century as the earliest, it's always been designed as a miniature mountain and water. Oh, just love it. Yeah, they love fish feeding. The family love fish feeding. The kids love them. I noticed that when the weather suddenly changed, they all disappear. You don't see them. Like suddenly drop off the temperature. They're just hiding. Very, very hot day, hiding. Mm-hmm. And then in the winter time, it's sort of like motionless, a little bit like hibernating. From the water, sometimes they like to swim up because like it's, but my understanding is basically it's like a massage for them. Yeah, and they like jumping. And then sometimes, yeah, I heard something about the breeding season. Yeah, they do like jumping. 31 years. We opened in 1988. Well, we always have koi fish. They're called koi carp. The patterns and colors are more like their personal fingerprints. Yeah, they're quite unique. Oh, that's they're very hardy fish. Very, very rarely we lose one. So we have some of the very big old calves. They are already over 40 years old. Of course, the koi has a lot of lucky colors, the gold, the orange, the red, that's all the lucky colors that in the traditional culture. Fish is always a lucky symbol because fish in Chinese pronunciation means yu. It's the same pronunciation that actually means that extra, because the family always wants to have something extra.